This video shows how to create an agent population and position the agents on the GIS map according to the location data, which will be read from the imported database. Let's assume that we're creating a model of the Taschen Book Publishers retail network. We want to place all the Taschen bookstores on the GIS map. We will read the addresses of the bookstores from the Excel file. Let's start with creating a new population of agents where each agent represents a bookstore. Drag the agent element from the agent palette onto your main agent diagram. In the New Agent wizard, choose Population of Agents. Since we're not using any of the existing agent types, we'll select the I want to create a new agent type option. Type Store as the name of the agent type and select the Use Database Table option to create and set up agents according to the data from the database table. On the next page of the wizard, browse for the file that contains the locations data. In our case, the Excel file contains one address column, which lists the addresses of the 12 Taschen bookstores. The header row of this column will serve as the name of the agent parameter, which is address in our case. After selecting the file, click the Show List of Tables button to load data from it. Now, we need to tie the location of the agents with the data from the database. Initially, AnyLogic proposes to create the address parameter and map it to the address column, but we'll rather use one of the AnyLogic built-in options. We double-click in the parameter column and select GIS location name from the drop-down list. This will link the geographical locations of agents in our population to the actual addresses that are stored in the database. Alternatively, you can read agent coordinates, latitude and longitude, from the database columns. Now, we'll choose the retail store 2D animation figure for our bookstores, which will represent them on the GIS map. The agent population is now fully set up. Click Finish. Notice that the agent's animation figure is currently located in the center of the map, which is normal since the actual positioning of the agents will be performed on the launch of the model. Let's run it then. This animation in the model status bar indicates that AnyLogic is currently downloading map tiles, which will be used by the model. Caching is finished, and you can see that AnyLogic has created the population of agents for the bookstores and has put the agents into the corresponding locations on the map. Note that the population consists of the 12 agents, which were created in accordance with the data specified in the database table. If the source data is formatted incorrectly, agents might be placed in wrong locations. Let's zoom into London to check if the Taschen store marked on the map is located in exactly the same spot as the actual store. Thanks for watching. We really enjoy Taschen books, and so should you. Come back for more AnyLogic video tutorials.